Hi, my name is Ed Young. I'm a pastor and a caster. I love to fish. When I'm not working, I'm on the water. Fish on! Yeah, baby! That's why I thought it would be great to bring some of my friends along to fish with me and learn a bunch. Today, joining me from the Potter's House is a man who needs no introduction, Bishop T.D. Jakes!
That is a good one there, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is going in the T.D. Jakes Hall of Fame.
Yeah, I'm tired of fishing alone, man. It'd be cool to have somebody here to fish with. Somebody that... I've always dreamed of fishing with certain people. Oh my gosh, you gotta be kidding me.
Hey.
No, it's not! Lean and
mean! No, I'm
Bishop,
working
how
on
you
it.
Doing, man?
I'm good, how you doing?
Good to see you.
Good to see you. You having any luck out here?
Not much.
Oh.
You're here now, though.
Oh, yeah.
Are you ready to fish?
Yeah, come on, let's do it.
Bishop Jakes, this is awesome.
I'll pray for fish.
We already got a bite, Bishop.
You got a bite?
Look at this, look.
Let's see.
Take it, take it. Take it, Bishop.
Let's see.
Take it.
Let's see.
Reel it with you. Try this.
I do that.
Yes, you do.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh my gosh!
Bishop!
Oh my gosh, Bishop!
What do we got here?
That is awesome! That quick!
I think you had the fish waiting on me.
No,
like
I did
Jesus.
Not. I did not. Look at
you were like Jesus.
Wow.
You had the fish on the other side of the boat.
It's incredible!
Oh my God!
Whoa!
It's huge!
Oh, that's a big one! Oh, Bishop Jakes! That is a nice catfish,
oh
Bishop.
My gosh.
Look at that one.
Huge.
Look. Have you ever caught one that big?
No.
That is a monster. That's a big one.
Good
Look
Lord.
At that.
Amazing.
You show up that quick, Bishop.
Amazing.
Now.
God is on our side.
He's on our side. Now.
You got a broken line, though.
here's a something about a catfish that's interesting, Bishop. And tell me if you know. Someone
I
taught
know
me
nothing.
This. Okay. Someone
nothing.
Taught me this a long time ago because I've grown up fishing. All right. This right here is razor sharp. That point,
uh-huh.
I mean, that'll go through your hand right here. That will. Mm. Okay. And then on these two sides, too, it'll go through your hand.
Mm.
And I've gotten stuck before. It'll mess you up. They have kind of a poison. So the way you hold them is you keep that down. You see what I'm saying to you?
Mm-hmm.
And then I come in behind those. But this is so big, I can't get my whole hand around him. Look at that.
Oh my God.
Look at that.
Hey, big fella.
Look at that.
Yeah. That doesn't happen every day.
No, it doesn't. That's a
wow.
big fish.
Yes, sir.
Awesome.
Good deal. We're good.
Woohoo!
He's happy Bishop. About that.
Yes, he's happy about it.
Catch and release.
Okay, tell me about this, Bishop. Okay, when it comes to fishing, what do you think about the Bible, Jesus? Just talk to me about fishing.
What I like about fishing, what it represents to me is one world going into another to bring things in.
Yes.
And you're fighting each one to get the other one in his element.
Yes.
If the fish could, he'd pull you in the water.
That's a big one.
And you're trying to pull him out into the air.
Yep.
And it's also so much like the kingdom. You have to go into the world, out of your element, and try to bring people in. And the Bible says, he that winneth souls is wise.
Yep.
And so there's a wisdom. You have to be aware of how to talk. There's a different language. There's a different... You use different kinds of bait for different kinds of fish.
Yeah.
And what church people understand, you can't go into the world and use church language and
That's
catch
fact.
The world. You,
yes.
you understand? You have to use the language that the world can relate to.
Right.
We have to get away from the mentality of thinking that everybody's coming to church.
That's a fact.
Yeah, the church has to go to them. Jesus said, go, not just come. He said, go, and we have to get out there.
Yeah, look at it. Look.
We got some right
Gosh,
here.
Gosh, Bishop.
We
that's
got
a big brim.
Right here.
Look at that brim. Bishop.
Oh, my gosh. We
now,
do.
That's a big one.
Wow.
Look at that.
Wow. He was hungry.
Bishop, thanks for fishing with me, man.
Oh, man, it's fun.
You know what I do? I do this alone a lot.
Do you?
Yeah, and I like fishing with people.
Yeah, of course. Anything's better when you got company.
That's the truth, isn't it?
Even if it's a rookie like me.
Is that beautiful?
Beautiful.
How do you like that?
So, Bishop, do you ever get very many of your ideas, like, from reading or listening to people, or not really that much?
Sometimes.
Sometimes, but not all the time.
Yeah, sometimes it's from anything. It could be a street sign.
Yes.
And if I get inspired by it, the next thing you know. But you are one of the most creative preachers I have ever seen.
Well, I appreciate it.
I mean, amazingly creative. And I would follow you, but I'm afraid if I came in the church riding on a motorcycle, I'd skin my knees or...
You have to be who you are.
Yeah.
But Bishop...
That is so
be,
true.
You be
that
you.
That is so very true.
Wait. Flip back.
Flip back.
Yeah, this line. So anyway, yeah, that's what we need to do, though, and you've done such an incredible job at that with all of your movies.
Thank you.
Which are unbelievable. I've seen most of them.
I'm going to tell you something I don't think that you know. The way I became a producer...
There's a lot of stuff I don't know.
You know a whole lot of stuff. I mean, you know how to fish.
So you're saying, go ahead about your movies.
But I was preaching for C3. Yes. For upon this rock, not that one, this rock, will I build my church and the gates of hell. Make some noise!
How did you,
And met the family from Heaven Is For Real.
At our conference?
Yes.
Excellent.
And he was one of your pastors, came up
that
to me.
That is awesome.
After the event and said, I want you to be the producer on this film.
That's unbelievable.
And that's how it came about.
That's great.
Right at C3.
That is awesome.
It's really incredible.
Yes, it is. Okay, Bishop, do you have a favorite sermon that you've ever done?
The spell is broken.
The spell is broken!
So Bishop, that's your favorite message?
Yeah, I think it's one of my favorite. You know, I tell people all the time, your best message is the one you needed the most. I don't care what it is.
That's right.
The best message I ever heard in my life is the message I needed the most at the time that I heard it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's really the truth.
I've often wondered this. Why do you think the disciples, most of them were fishermen?
You know something, I think it's a very interesting thing because, and this is something that I think we've kind of gotten away from.
Okay.
We have gotten more into preaching than winning souls.
Okay.
And we need to understand that when a guy fishes, especially with a rod and a reel, he has an encounter with the fish in a way that we have gotten away from. It used to be that preachers themselves witness in the grocery store,
that's
anywhere.
Right.
Didn't need a mic, didn't need a crowd. What's important about that is people will do what you do. And if you're not a soul winner, it's hard to teach. You can teach what you know, but you reproduce what you are. I got something here.
Bishop, you're wearing the fish out. This is you are, as we say in the fishing world, you're putting on a clinic.
I like that.
Oh, that's cool. We lost our worm.
Okay, now you know what too? I might do? Sure. I might put this fish on another one as bait to catch a giant one.
Oh, really?
Just stay right there.
Okay.
I might catch a giant, baby!
Now you show me how it's done.
Okay. No, still fish that. We're gonna keep this out here.
Okay.
To catch a giant one. We're just gonna let it, we're gonna let that fish just kind of move around. And we'll just sit it right over here, and we're gonna still do what we do.
Okay.
But we'll just watch. I always like to do that. Have one bait out there for a giant.
Yeah.
And then this one, and we can catch a giant on this too, but I agree with that.
Yeah, we have really forgotten the simplicity of relationship. And it not only shows in soul winning, it also shows in how we treat each other.
Yep. Oh, yeah.
And I think it's because it's predominantly men, and men have a propensity to always want to fix things.
Yep.
We're so busy trying to fix people, we forgot how to love them.
That's right, man.
You see?
I love it.
And if you love me, then I'll let you fix me. Right. But if you try to fix me and I don't think you love me, I'm going to resent you.
Yep.
So we have to pass the love test. Now, why do you choose this particular type of line? We got something.
Okay, Bishop.
Here. All right.
Here you go. Look at this, Bishop.
Oh, my gosh, that's a big one. That's a big one.
Got to reel it in.
Reel it in.
I don't know.
Hurry up.
That's a good one, Bishop.
That is a good one there, sir.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
This is going in the T.D. Jakes Hall of Fame, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a bass. Look at that. Look at that. That's a big mouth bass, large mouth bass, Bishop. Look at that.
I'm going to get it.
Look at it.
I'm going to get him.
Wow.
Oh, wow.
Wow, Bishop.
He is not happy with us.
Look at that fish he ate. Yeah. Look at that. Big bait, big fish.
Oh, my gosh.
Big bait, big fish, Bishop. Look.
Oh, my gosh.
Big bait.
He's right in his mouth.
Yes, sir. Yeah. Take your thumb. That's all you gotta do, just grab it.
Okay.
That's it. You have to hold it. Okay. You just hold it straight down. How's that?
This is as good as it gets.
His first bass.
Oh, and the fish stories that are gonna come out of this.
You know it. Now, Bishop, do you have anything to say about your fishing trip here, this fishing trip? Any how do you describe it? What would you say?
I think it's wonderful. I think it expresses fellowship between pastors who live in the same city, that we have the kind of relationship that we can come together and do
that
sort of thing. It's very important. Not only the life lessons that you learn, I think we've forgotten how to be friends.
Yes.
And so many pastors are lonely.
That's right.
They need somebody to talk to where they feel safe, that they get them.
Yep.
And so I think there's a powerful message just in the illustration of us coming together in the same city.
The only thing I didn't bring that I normally bring when I fish are cigars. You ever smoke cigars?
Let me tell you something. If you catch me with a cigar in my mouth on camera, they kill me. Cut the camera off, we'll talk about it.